contribution, catching 5 passes for 42 yards Sunday against the Chiefs. Belichick said Gordon's role in the offense is expanding weekly. Stacey, how should we expect Gordon's role to get bigger as the season moves on within Belichick's offense?
Well, Belichick told us something right there. He normally doesn't. If you asked him, hey, what's Edelman going to do this week? He said, we're gonna put the best players out there, going to put a play out there. I don't know. But he lets you know. Josh, every week. So, obviously, the thing with Belichick is, if I give you an assignment, I want you to master that assignment. And then your chances of getting an increased role, they get better. And that's the way it is with Belichick. He's on a merit system. Like, you earn the amount of playing time you're going to get. And obviously, Josh is doing well day to day in the meetings. He's thriving in their system. So you can expect his role to increase. And to me, the more he learns in the system, the more the game becomes easy to him, because you cannot double cover him. You cannot roll coverage to him. You cannot sit there and play zone, because Tom Brady will pick you apart. So most of the time, Josh Gordon is going to have individual coverage, single, and a guy in bump and run. And he is too big, too strong, and too fast for you to tell him what you're getting ready to do. Because you can't play. Why can't you play zone? Because Tom Brady will pick you apart. He will run routes in front of you all day, or he'll run double moves to bring you up and then go past you. So you have to be able to vary the coverage, and you have to be able to play some zone cover two where the corner is going to jam him and the safety is going to come over top the head.
Tell the audience why they can't double him. You just kind of said it in passing. You're like, you can't double him. You explained why they can't play zone. Why can't in the Patriots offense?
Rob Gronkowski is the number one wide receiver, and they're trying to take him out. And when they try to not take him out, they try to double him, and they double Edelman. Now, there was a play in the goal line where that Kansas City doubled three players. It's very, very rare. They doubled James White coming out of the backfield. They doubled Edelman and Gronk. So I'm just going, if Josh Gordon is just a shell of himself, he should be successful, because what they're asking him to do is very easy. And for his skill set, as far as getting off the bump and run, that's what he's able to do at a high level.
See, what percentage of interceptions is on the receiver, not the quarterback?
60%.
It's a sliding scale, depending on when you ask, Chris.
Sometimes it's 60%.
Something like that. And so we talk about with interceptions, you can apply something similar to incompletions. In the game against the Chiefs, Brady targeted Gordon twice. It went incomplete. It felt to me like both of those were on Josh, that Brady wasn't inaccurate with his pass, that Josh was not where Brady thought he was going to be. The one that comes to my mind's eye was up the far sideline. Josh kept going. It seemed like clear Brady expected him to run a stop. And then in the end zone, there was an incompletion where Brady thought he was going to sit in the zone, and he kept going across instead of sitting in the soft part of the zone. That, instead of being a touchdown, they ended up settling for a field goal there. I bring those points up for this reason. If that stuff gets cleaned up, this is, as long as Josh stays healthy, an all-pro addition. If that stuff gets cleaned up, then all of a sudden the Patriots have found a way to add a real difference maker mid-season and gave up almost nothing. Gave up a fifth, seventh-round pick swap.
Like, yeah, I have to temper the expectations, because saying he's an all-pro, even if he was in an offense that's going to target him 10 times, we couldn't say that he's going to be all-pro. We don't know if he has the overall endurance. We don't know if he has the ability to be able to concentrate in those pressure settings. We don't know if they put the game plan in and feature him, how he responds to that. All right? So we can't say. It's a great addition, but we can't put, as far as being a premier player, and is he that player ever again? He's a guy who's got a lot of talent, who's in a great situation, and I'm not going to make any more of that.
The biggest encouraging number for Josh Gordon as in his increased role is his first game, he played 18 snaps. His second game, he played 18 snaps. Sunday night against the Chiefs, he played 63 snaps. I mean, Gronk only played 77. Edelman, 71. So you are seeing him becoming more of a full-time player with them.
Yeah, and Jenna, as you pointed out, they had extra time. So that's why you saw 18-18. You saw it bump up to 63, because they had played on the previous Thursday night.
They had the
extra time, had huge advantage. That's why we saw Josh also more Sunday night.
All right, let's take a break from that. Coming up, is it time for the Giants to move on from Eli Manning? That's next on First Things First.
Odell said sign him for an extension.
I love that guy.
That's my guy.
Oh, we got to finish our box.
Tuesday night.